it's your brother Sara Soon Sadie, and I'm back at y'all ass again with this real fucking talk. Okay, I want to continue on with how the black man, you know what I'm saying, can spark a fire up on this black woman. You understand what I'm saying? And believe me, family, I'm gonna give you some pointers, and I want you to go to work on that queen immediately. All right? You know, she been waiting on you, nigga, to tighten your shit up. Here's an opportunity. You just need a couple of pointers from your brother, Sara Soon Sadie. I'm going to help you out. Okay? Now, let me tell you something. To my brother. Look, we hang on the block all day long. You know we do. We get up. We hook up with the fellas. We hit the block. We hit the court. You understand what I'm saying? Hit the stone. Light up something. Sip a little something. Get the chitter-chattering, watch the game. You don't spend time, the proper time, quality time with your queen. You got to have that quality time, huh? You have to prioritize, you know, what's important to you, okay? And the black woman should be at the top. I don't even understand you. I really don't, huh? Because, you know, I'd be at the crib, for real, taking care of business. See, you motherfuckers stay away from the crib too goddamn long. And you wonder why a nigga done crept through the back door, and you understand, in the silky sheets and shit with your queen. Alright? Cause you ain't spending no quality time with her. And when that shit get to deteriorating, listen to me, fellas. I'm not at all, you understand, condoning everything that go on, you understand, between you and your queen. Both ways. But at the same time, we got to know when it's time to cut the bullshit. You know what I'm saying? We get to arguing, and these motherfucking arguments go on for way too long. You understand what I'm saying? We got to prioritize what is really special to us. And if the woman is special to us, we'll put her at the top of the list. So whatever you're doing in your day, you make sure you take care of that queen first. See what's her needs. You see what, you know, emotionally, spiritually, and physically, what her needs is. And tend to your woman. You know, sometimes they be going through shit at work. You know what I'm saying? They need, you know, an ear and a shoulder to lean on. And some advice. You know what I'm saying? To help them through shit. Because they go through a lot of shit just like we do. And, you know, ask your queen, what's, you know, how was her day? You know, when she come in. You know, and if things ain't right, you know what I'm saying? Pull her close. Let her know she at home. And home is her refuge, where she could come and always find peace. And so when she come home, you come home, the home is a place for peace. You don't want to be going through all that bullshit. You keep that shit out in the streets. And so we got to prioritize. Okay, and number two, brother, you know, we can't be cussing them queens. We can't do that. Our sons is watching us. Our daughters is watching us. Okay, and so when you get to cussing them queens, you know, that's a no-no. You know, your daughter look at that shit, and she say, you know, she gonna begin to think that that's okay. And so when a nigga cuss her, she gonna, you know, she not gonna handle it properly. You know, she supposed to say, no, motherfucker, this the queen. You can't step over here. Like, some queens, once they see their father do shit, if he's there, then they accept another nigga treating them that way. And you don't want to put your queen in that predicament. You don't want to put your daughter in that predicament. And you don't want to show your son them negative traits. They're negative traits. You know what I'm saying? And so let's prioritize. Let's put our black woman first. Let's put our children first. Hey, put your family at the top of the list. Okay. Now, I know a lot of you niggas is hard as hell. Okay? You niggas ain't, you can't say I love you. Okay? Another nigga come right along and tell that woman, you know, he love her and sweep off her goddamn feet. You got to tell that woman you love her. Okay? It means a whole lot to them sisters, you know, and not just say it, but mean it, you know what I'm saying? If you with that woman, nigga, you know you love that woman, okay? Don't be so motherfucking hard, nigga, till you lose the best thing you got going for you, okay? A lot of the things that's going wrong in the relationship, it's not all her. It's some of you too, motherfucker. And so you got to look at this shit and, you know, and balance, you know, have a balanced approach to the relationship, to whereas you also account for the things that you doing wrong, okay, for the both of them. But don't be cussing that woman, okay, at all, and tell her you love her. It means a lot to a sister to hear that. You know what I'm saying? You know when that woman come and kiss you, say, oh, baby, I love you. You love her. Okay, it means a whole lot. Make a motherfucker stand up strong. You know what I'm saying? The queens will do that for you. Okay, to my brother. I know that you used to going down to Pizza Hut, you know, the KFC, and you eating, you know, a whole goddamn bucket of goddamn chicken and all type of wedges and shit. Nigga, you got to hit that gym, okay? And you ain't got to be no motherfucker Hulk Hogan type of motherfucker. You know, big old dumb looking ass motherfucker. All you got to do is to have a firm body. So when that queen roll over on you at night, she feel secure and safe. But goddamn it, if you look like a string bean and motherfucker come in there, nigga, choke you to goddamn, you know, put the queen and the family in distress and shit, you got to be showing an appearance of strength. And plus, the queens like it. Yeah, they love it. You know what I'm saying? You know, they get, you know, when you're hard body, you understand what I'm saying? You gonna get respect from the queen. Don't let them tell you nothing different, okay? They want a hard body brother in that household, in their bedroom, particularly, okay? Let's not get away from that, okay? And then, when you're in shape, when you call to lay it down, you can put it down, huh? Ain't breathing hard or nothing. You understand? You then you can do all kind of tricks and shit when you got your strength and shit. You know you strong, motherfucker, do all kind of strength. You know, tricks and shit. You know, shit that the average motherfucker can't do because he ain't got the strength. You know what I'm saying? And so when you're strong, you know, it arouses the sister. You know what I'm saying? I'm telling you the truth. Get your shit together. Go and get your little weight set. Go in your basement. Get you some dumbbells. Do you some push-ups. Nigga, get on your health. It's good for you and your family. Okay? And then in that bedroom, you understand what I'm saying? You're going to do some miraculous things, and the queen is going to appreciate it. Now, okay, we know once a month or twice a month, y'all had that special time, okay? And when you plan it out, saying, yeah, we're gonna go to the little, we're going to find us a nice little hotel downtown. Get us a room, you know what I'm saying? Get us a couple bottles of Moe. You understand what I'm saying? We're going to chill, get a little lingerie. You understand? Go in the room, God damn it. And you got to get a queen a special request. You got to give her a special request. You know why? Well, you know, you don't give it to her all the time. You know, that's the special request night. You understand what I'm saying? And a lot of you niggas, y'all know what time it is. Y'all know what time it is. The queen might ask you. You understand what I'm saying? To taste a little sugar. Huh? Okay. Oh, sad you didn't went too goddamn. Motherfuckers doing it anyway. Shut the fuck up. Don't put it all on me. Huh? You's a freak any goddamn way. The fuck you mad at me? They mad at me because I said you're talking about tasting a little sugar. Hey! This is what it is. And so, you know, every now and then you can't go down all the time. You spoil them like that. You got to give, you know, you got to have them fiending for that shit. You know what I'm saying? And so, you know, twice a month, you know what I'm saying? You work it out with the queen where, you know, you got a special, and whatever the request is, except one goddamn thing, and y'all know what that is. We're not playing on that other side. You know what I'm saying? We're not going there. Keep that shit, you know, with them crackers and shit. We're not going there with all that dumb shit. But I ain't got no problem with the brown sugar, all right? But that other shit, y'all can cut that shit out. Look, the queens They be at work. Let me tell you something. If you send her some flowers, at work, you know what I'm saying? Send her a little gift along with the flowers. You know what I'm saying? Like I say, you know, you can never go wrong with lingerie. You know what I'm saying? Because them queens like that shit. You get her some little fly lingerie. Go on down there, get her some fly high heels. You understand what I'm saying? And you know, this is how you do it. If you want this shit popping, you got to add some spice to your shit. If you's a Puritan type motherfucker and all y'all do is roll over and do it, that shit is old. Motherfuckers ain't doing that no more. You know what I'm saying? You got to put some spice in this shit, okay? So you send a little gift, you know, for lunch. You know what I'm saying? To send a little gift and let the man bring it to a desk. And when the mother queens see him get that gift and them flowers, you know, they gonna say, damn, I wish I had a man like that. You know what I'm saying? That queen gonna be smiling, gonna be big as hell, cause a man didn't show the love. You know what I'm saying? It ain't nothing wrong with that, fellas. Quit being all hard, cause another nigga gonna come along and do that. And then when your queen is gone and she with that other nigga, you're gonna be fucked up. Avoid that. Avoid that altogether. Listen, if you didn't got into an argument during the day, never go to bed mad at each other. Alright? Work that shit out. You know what I'm saying? Love is the key. You know what I'm saying? We've been going through a lot of changes since we've been here in America. But we got to understand we is all we got. You know what I'm saying? The love for the black man is in our heart. And the love for the black woman is in our heart. We got to go on and mash this shit together, family, and do what's best for us. We doing a lot of shit to our own selves. You know what I'm saying? And we got to stop that. We are, you know, sometimes we could be our worst enemy, you know? And when we come to realize that and become conscious of that, we got to do better. You know what I'm saying? The home is a place for peace. You know, and so with that as the foundation of the family, you know, things are starting to work out. Communication. Keep the level of conversation at a level, you know what I'm saying, where we can all get our ideas across, what we trying to say, and listen without attacking the other person. You understand? But never go to bed upset at your queen, at your king. That's just not the right thing to do, okay? Well, you can make up and lay down and hold that woman tight and go on to sleep. That's the best decision that you can make. Lastly, but not least, black man. Let me tell you something. When you go back in history and when you go to and look at the black man's glory, when the black man was at his most glorious stage in history, his woman was his God. His woman was his God. You understand what I'm saying? You got to be right with your woman. That's the first attribute of being a man. You got to be right with your queen. You understand what I'm saying? Because ain't nothing, no children, no love, no nothing gonna go on in the black family unless you is right with your woman. And so, you know, cut out all that hard shit. You understand what I'm saying? We still gonna be hard. But when it comes to our queen, hey, you got to yield to that woman and work it out with her. And listen to her and encourage her to be her best. That's the best answer. You know what I'm saying? Don't let these old weak-ass niggas talk you out of a good woman and put you in a predicament to lose your house, your household, and your family. That's the most important thing, okay? And so to my brothers, I know that, hey, we got a lot of things going on in our life. I understand that. But take the time to make a better household for your family. This is your brother, Sarasu, and said he said, hey, arm yourself with knowledge. Bang on that wicked-ass beast daily. Liberation through education. Step it up, brothers. I know you can do it. Black power.